Now we will deal with the areas covered under ergonomics. We just had a brief discussion in the last session, end of my last lecture. So I will continue the same point. So areas covered under ergonomics are: first one is communication between man and machine, working environment, human anatomy and posture while using the machine, and energy expenditure in hand and foot operations. So first one, there has to be a proper communication between man and machine. Working environment, the person who is working on a machine, so there has to be a proper working environment so that the person will work with his full efficiency and effectiveness. Human anatomy and posture while using the machine also plays very, very important role. Suppose the person who is working on a machine is having a proper posture while using the machine, so he will have a less fatigue and he can work with more efficiency. Also, we have to take care that, or we have to also consider the energy expenditure by a person who is working on a machine in his hand and foot operations. Now we will see the man-machine relationship. Here in this figure you can see the person is working on a machine. Okay, so man and machine, and also there are some parameters like working environment, which includes lightning, noise, temperature, humidity and air circulation. So ergonomics not only deals with the man and machine, but it also deals with the working environment, which includes lightning, noise, temperature, humidity and air circulation. So it is a combination of all these is called as a ergonomics. So see here, the person who is working on a machine, initially what he is doing, after from machine display, he is getting some information. That information he is interpret. Okay, he will see from his eyes, he will interpret, and accordingly he will take the corrective action on the machine controls, and again according to those actions, again the machine will show the display. Again from that display he will receive the information, and again his brain will exercise or interpret that information, and again that person will take the corrective action. So this is a cycle, or this is a relationship between a man and machine, and while doing this, these are the working environment parameters which also plays very, very important role. See here, a man or a user receives the information from the machine display through the sense of sense organs, and he or she then takes the corrective action on the machine controls using his hands or feet. Right, so we have seen the man and machine is a closed loop system which is influenced by the working environment factors such as lightning, noise, temperature, humidity, air circulation, etc. And the communication between man, that is user, and the machine consists of two very important parameters, that is nothing but displays and controls, because from the display we receive the information and from controls we can take the corrective action. Means the man-machine system has two important units, one is displays and second one is the controls. So first we will deal with the types of displays. So there are two basic types of displays. First one is a visual display and second one is the auditory display. So we'll start with the design of visual displays. What are its type? So displays are the devices through which a man or a user receives the information from the machine. Okay, suppose you are working on a computer, so from the screen or a display you will receive an information from that particular machine. A good display device is one which allows the proper combination or speed, accuracy and sensitivity of a display. So these are the characteristics of a good display device. The display device can be broadly classified into two categories. One is a qualitative display and second one is a quantitative display. So we will see first what is a qualitative display. The display which indicate only the condition or state without giving any values are known as displays or I will say are known as qualitative displays. Okay, the examples of qualitative displays are traffic signals, on-off indicators. The qualitative displays are having following types, like circular dial, straight legend, and colored lights. So here, if you'll see the circular dial, straight legend, and colored lights. So these displays does not providing any values. Okay, so they are indicating only the condition or state. They are not giving any values. That's why these are called as qualitative displays. Okay, so here I will just add it. So it is a qualitative display, means it is going to give us only the values. It is not going to give the any numbers, values in terms of numbers. We will see what are the examples, like circular dial. So see here, if at all I want to know the state, so I can see that this particular pointer gives me if the particular thing is a cold or a warm or a hot. So it is not giving any value to me in terms of numbers. So it is just indicating the state of a system or a state of a machine, whether it is cold, warm or hot. So this is a type of circular dial, because we are dealing with these three types: circular dial, straight legend and colored lights. So first, this is a circular dial which is indicating the state of a system. It is not giving values in terms of numbers. Again, straight legend. So see, this is a pointer. It can move linearly to indicate whether the system is hot, warm or cold. And third one is nothing but colored lights. So traffic signal are the best example of colored lights. So again, red, orange or yellow or green. So these are also going to give the state of a system. It is not giving any value. So all these displays are coming under the qualitative displays. Now we will see what are the quantitative displays. The displays which give the quantitative measurements or numerical informations are known as quantitative displays. Or in simple word, I will say the display which gives the readings in terms of some numbers. So those are called as quantitative displays. The examples of a quantitative displays are voltmeter, ammeters, speedometers, which we see in case of our bikes or cars, energy meters and watches. These are the examples of quantitative displays, because they are giving us the information in terms of numerical values. The quantitative displays are of following types. Again, it has been divided into some types, like first one is moving pointer and fixed scale type displays. Means there are some displays in which pointer is moving and scale is fixed. Second one is fixed pointer and moving scale type displays. So here pointer is fixed but the scale is moving. And third one is the digital display. So we will see moving pointer and fixed scale type displays. So in case of moving pointer and fixed scale type display, there are some figures that we will see. So here characteristic of this is as the characteristic or I will say the feature of this particular type of display is it is easy to read than a fixed pointer moving scale. It is most common in use, moving pointer and fixed scale. So these are the examples. So there are types like circular scale, semicircular scale, horizontal scale and vertical scale. So if you'll observe, the scale is fixed and the pointer is moving. So in case of our speedometer of our bike or in case of speedometer of a car, you can see this pointer is moving and scale is fixed. Here also you can see this pointer is moving here linearly and the scale is fixed. So this is a vertical scale. Same things happen. Scale is fixed but the pointer is moving. So it is called as a moving pointer and fixed scale type displays. The second one is fixed pointer and moving scale. So where it is used? Generally, when the values are to be read over the wide range. So at that time, the fixed pointer open display are more efficient than moving pointer fixed scale type. Means what? When we are going to use this fixed pointer and moving scale, whenever we have to take the reading over wide range. So at that time we are using this. So best example is the weighing machine on which we stand generally. So I will say analog type weighing machine. So if you stand on that, the pointer remains fixed, but the scale moves. Okay, and we will come to know our weight. So see here, circular scale. This is a circular scale. So here, suppose this is a weighing machine. I will stand on this. So this particular pointer remains fixed, and this scale is going to rotate, right? And the reading which comes in front of this pointer, that will be the exact reading of this fixed pointer and moving scale. So it is for a circular one. Again, for horizontal type. So again here, pointer is fixed, but the scale is moving. And here in the vertical type also, open window. Open window means what? You can see all the readings. Pointer is fixed, but the scale is moving. So weighing bridge, or I will say weighing machine, is a best example of fixed pointer moving scale type displays. Next one is digital displays. So these are the most accurate type of all displays. So generally it is going to give us the exact value in terms of numbers. So these are the examples. Suppose this is a watch, a digital watch, 11:47 a.m. So it is giving us the exactly value in terms of numbers. And also here, if at all we want to see the temperature, 38 degrees Celsius. So this is also a digital display. Now we will see the second type, that is nothing but the auditory display. So when auditory displays are used, so these are based upon human sense of hearing, and sometimes compared to visual displays, auditory displays can monitor the performance superior, so that these devices are suitable as warning devices. Okay, suppose you have already seen this. Suppose you are on a railway platform and you are moving around, and all of a sudden each and every time you can't concentrate on that particular display, that which train is coming on which platform. But there is also an announcement which is going on that this particular train is coming on this platform. So other than looking at the display, if you are hearing it, so these auditory displays also plays very, very important role. Okay, and these are based on human sense of hearing. And suppose sometimes there is a fire in a particular industry, so that alarm or a buzzer buzzes, and all of a sudden everyone will come to know that, okay, so something has mishap here, so we have to move to a safe region or safe zone. Okay, so these are the types of auditory displays. So we will see when the auditory displays are preferred. So it is preferred when the information is simple and short. The information is based on the events depending upon the time and immediate action required. Okay, so in case of fire or just on the railway platform, the station or the platform on the railway station, if there is a change in the arrival of a train and its platform, at that time we can use this auditory display. No proper location for visual display. So if there is no proper location, then we can go for auditory display or announcement. The operator cannot stand in front of display panel all the time. So this is also one of the parameters, that a particular operator cannot stand every time in front of a display panel. So at that time we can use this auditory display. Some of the common auditory displays are horns, whistle, siren, buzzer, bell and oscillator. So all these are the some common auditory displays. Now we have seen the different types of displays. Now we will see the ergonomic consideration in the design of displays. So the scale which has been used for the display, it should be clear and legible. The sizes of letters and figures must be adjusted to the expected distance between eye and information of the display. Okay, so size and height of a letter or a figure, it has to be in a proper size. And for that, the following formula has been used. Like, suppose if at all I want to calculate the height of letter or figure in terms of millimeter, that has to be equal to visual distance in millimeters divided by 200. Okay, visual distance between the display and the person who is working on that machine divided by 200 will be nothing but the height of a letter on the display. The scale should be divided into linear progression like 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So this should be a linear progression. It should not be like 0, 5, all of a sudden 25, 45 like that. Okay, so it has to be with a linear progression like this. The number of subdivision between the number division should be as less or as minimum as possible. So we will try to keep the number of subdivisions as less as possible. Again, vertical numbers should be used for a moving pointer type display with a circular scale as shown in figure 1A and B. So see here in this figure, I will say that the number should be vertical when the pointer is moving and scale is fixed. Okay. And the number should be radially oriented when the pointer is fixed and scale is moved, which has been shown in this particular figure. Okay. So if pointer is moving, scale is fixed, at that time we have to use the numbers, or we have to use the vertical numbers. In this case, where the pointer is moving and scale is fixed, and in this type, the pointer is fixed but the scale is moving, so these numbers should be radially oriented, because whenever they are coming in front of this particular pointer, it will be properly aligned with this pointer. Again, we will see the vertical numbers should be used for vertical and horizontal scales as shown in this figure 3 and 4. So see here, we are using the number verticals only. These are vertically aligned. We are not writing the numbers horizontally. Means what? It has to be vertically aligned, means it should be like this. It should not be like this 1, 2, 3, etc. So these numbers should be vertically aligned. Okay, as shown in this figure as well as this figure, irrespective of pointer is moving or scale is fixed, or scale is moving or pointer is fixed. So we have to use the vertical numbers, okay, for these horizontal and vertical scales. The numbering should be done in clockwise for a circular scale, and from left to right on a horizontal scale, and from bottom to top on a vertical scale. So see, yes, this is a vertical circular scale. So the numbering has been done in the clockwise direction. And for a horizontal scale, the numbering is done from left to right. And for a vertical scale, the numbering is done from bottom to top. Okay. The pointer should have a knife edge with a mirror in a dial to minimize the parallax error while taking the reading. So, if at all we want to minimize the parallax error, the pointer should have a knife edge with a mirror in dial. Okay. So, these are the criteria that we have to follow while designing the displays.